فأما من طغى وآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجحيم هي المأوى.
Time was the time, bro.
No, wait. Listen to my question. My question, don't kick understand this. Donkey, I'm gonna speak to Donkey. My question, does Dr. Gali says the only minute for Salah. If anyone watch my videos with the most of the time I'm speaking to him, he's not listening, he's checking his phone. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
When I spoke to you about you're a Christian, it's not English language. Why? Because in English language, the son doesn't mean the father of himself, the father doesn't mean the son of himself.
But the Bible
says. Hand him out, yeah. So that's what I'm saying. So we should put him out. Therefore, we should not translate, we should not trust the English translators, because they are translating a text in a wrong way. Because in English language, as English is not my first language, however, I can understand the basic of it. The father is not the son is not the father of himself. The son can be the father of someone else, but not the father of himself. You understand that, Paperboy? So don't tell me we are doing the same.
What's the matter of the book? Who's the matter of the book?
As I said, Dr. Kali, he is the head of linguistics at Al Azhar University. So he says, when he puts 23:56, he puts in brackets literally shower prayers.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is obviously
shower what? Wait, first of all, Dr. Gali, he said shower his prayers. In the prayers, what does it mean in the language as well? Does it mean blessings?
Praising is a form of worship.
No.
Praising is a form of worship.
Of course, when God bless you, yes.
So when you ask me which scholar, so that's why I said, what do you mean by scholar? Then you started showboating. That's me showboating. So then, because obviously, then I said, Al-Athi, because he obviously goes.
Al-Athi doesn't say that.
But he gives the definitions of Salah and Salawah.
No, but
let me finish. Because the thing is, the word Salah predates Islam.
Yeah.
So therefore, they talk about the origin, the root of it as well.
Yeah.
It comes from Salah and it's Islam.
Does it predate Islam?
Yes, it does.
All of them say, even linguistically, there's a difference between legislatively definition, linguistically definition. When they say linguistically meaning, predate Islam. Legislatively meaning, they call it Islamic legislation, definition, okay? So when you come, hear me out, when you go to Ibn Athir, and all the scholars, that even linguistically, there is a different meaning, different roots for it. So the Quran mentioned there is 8 roots for the word Salat. So it depends on that context again. So
not just
mercy. So even Dr. Gali, said, he never said Prophet Muhammad, Allah prayed to Prophet Muhammad. He said Allah showered him with his prayer. In English language, if I say I'm showering you with my prayer, I don't know which one I say I'm praying to you. Understand? So even that, I don't trust it.
But if you shower me, it's still a supplication. Because if someone supplicating for me, you're not giving praise to me.
No, showering prayer.
Exactly.
Anyway, that. But what I'm saying, so Dr. Gali, for the sake of argument, you know what I did his statement? I put it in the bin. You know why? He's still alive. I'm gonna contact him. Because he cannot be the hand.
Let me
finish my point. I didn't say he's not. You know, I watch many videos with many people. I don't let them finish your point. No, I'm saying, but let me finish my point. Why? Because anyone that knows Arabic language, he knows a song that has different meaning. For this man to say,
he knows better than his scholar, basically.
Look, look, look to him. His honesty. No, let me have a finish. So what happened to 1,000 scholars? Should we reject them?
Wait.
Please.
What's your qualification to reject Dr. Ghali?
I tell you, Can you debate it? That's why I'm frustrated. Let me finish my point. Please be honest, because you should be honest, correct? He doesn't have a point when he says Shamsi cannot go against Dr. Ghali. But then I'm not taking it from my own hand. I'm using Ibn Athir. I'm using Ibn Abbas. I'm bringing a big authority against one person. So, listen to my question. Does your friend has a point against me?
I'm bringing classical scholars.
If you bring Jewish classical scholars, and then you bring someone who is a modern scholar, who would against one person, yeah, from scholar of the Jewish, who would against the classical scholars of the Jewish, which one you take?
Okay, now this is the thing.
No, I'm asking a question. Which one you take?
I'm answering. Allow the long stop to answer the question.
Yeah, answer.
Yeah.
The scholar that he's quoting, is he negating that?
That's right, he's not negating.
This is what it means.
Yeah.
So based upon the little knowledge he has,
yeah,
this is what it means.
Yeah, but this is not little knowledge though, because this guy,
his
honesty is like the Cambridge of Islamic University. It's one of the best
universities. Answer my question.
He rejected top university.
Answer my question, Paperboy.
And he's the head of
Lincoln. Paperboy, answer my question. First of all, Azhar University, I don't take him serious.
Paperboy doesn't understand my question clearly.
Why? Because he's so busy with looking through the phone. My question to you, name me one scholar said that the meaning of a salat does not mean mercy and blessings, which only means prayers.
Write the question.
So I said, bring me any scholar said the only meaning for prayer, it is a salat. That's what my question. He brought Dr. Ghali. But when I ask him, let me finish my point. When I ask him, now I made it clearer. Does Dr. Ghali says the only meaning for salat is a prayer? Said no. So therefore you answer a question which I never asked. Is that clear?
So Hijab was lying basically. Hijab was lying when he said Allah
pray for
him.
Hijab is not my student. So ask him if he's lying or not.
And
I don't know what Hijab said.
When you meet Al-Afi, he describes it. I don't have it.
Don't lie. Al-Afi said there's many meaning for it. And he said when it comes to Allah, it means what? Showing mercy.
So bring up the Al-Afi.
Here. Qurtubi caught him.
Yeah. Okay, let's check. Al-Athir talks about the root of the word, which predates the Islamic. Therefore, my argument is this. The word Salah was used, and obviously for Muslims, yes, they would say it doesn't linguistically make sense.
If only they knew.
Is a blessing or mercy, because it doesn't fit with the narrative that God would pray. But then this was a word that was taken from pre-Islam. But even though you have words, because if you went from pre-Islam,
again, you're lying. I only showed them pre-Islamic days. Salat has many meanings.
Okay, show me the.
But he's
show
listening.
Show me the meaning.
Here, I'll show you.
Not post-Islamic.
represent their meaning. What they said, the root for it, linguistically. The root for it, there's 8 meaning.
Okay?
So not just that.
Okay. Because obviously there's many words, like if you want to use baraka or rapa, it's very simple. But you know every single word.
Every single word.
So where's the
rather, no,
Allah distinguishes the words from blessings, mercy and prayer.
Allah distinguishes of Christians, right? Okay. He doesn't differentiate
Allah
between...
Allah distinguishes
sacrilege. I already clarified that to them, but...
They can argue with...
No, you can, you can.
With Allah?
You know why? Because Allah mentioned the Quran that on the day of Qadr, which is the day of Ramadan, Allah said the angels will descend and the ruh. The ruh is Gabriel. So what Allah said the angels will descend and Gabriel? In Arabic language, they call when you generalize something and specify it. But we're speaking to someone who cannot even understand
so
English language. He doesn't differentiate between the Son and the Father.
Okay.
So
I'm
looking for it. No, wallah, you're an embarrassment, to be honest.
You say you're going against
remember,
Allah.
You're the same
you
guy. You remember, you're the same
you're going
guy.
Against Allah. You
that
say,
the Father
I can go against Allah. You said I can go against Allah.
Remember who I'm speaking to. I remember, there's two people that remember who I'm speaking to.
Well, right.
But they're doing us a favor, honestly. They're making Christians look bad. So
no, hijab does a favor.
Thank you, hijab. Big favor.
Thank
keep
you,
doing
hijab.
What you're doing.
Thank you for having hijab.
Anybody with half an ounce of sincerity will see who's sincerely according to Allah and who's just trying to block. Who's just trying to hate, street hate you. They suck on words, but you apply the same criteria to them. They don't even know okay, who said these words.
Yeah, so. So this is from Ibn
Asakir. Ibn Asakir.
Yeah. Have you read? Do you know this?
Ibn Asakir is also.
Yeah. So obviously this. Yeah, but let me.
You said Ibn Athir.
No, I'm giving you.
I know the hadith. Allah barik ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Kama barakta Ibrahim. Allah said to send salat and the barakat.
Barakat.
To send salat and the barakat.
What do you mean?
When Allah say, when we say, oh Allah,
no,
it's not, that's called generalizing. Please, don't embarrass yourself.
Let him read the hadith.
Read it, okay.
Yeah, okay. So this is the hadith where it says, the Israelites said to Moses, does your Lord pray? And Moses said, fear Allah, O son of Israel. Then Allah said, O Musa, what did your people say? Musa said, my Lord, you already know. They said, does your Lord pray? So obviously the Israelites approached Moses to ask whether he prays, not whether he gives barakah or mercy. Then Allah said, tell them, my prayer is for my servants, is that my mercy should precede my anger. If it were not so, I would have destroyed them.
He just moved to you. He just moved
just
to you.
He just moved to you. Bro, are you doing this? So the prayer means mercy. So the hadith explains.
Say again.
You have to tell me what drugs he's smoking.
That's a great deal.
Say again.
All right. So the hadith starts. It says the Israelites said to Moses, does your Lord pray? So they ask a specific question. Does he pray?
Yes. No mercy. Pray.
So he said, Musa said, fear Allah. Because he said, fear Allah, because obviously he's shocked by the question they asked him. So then he says, O sons of Israel. Then Allah says, O Musa, what does your people say? Moses said, O my Lord, you already know. They said, does your Lord pray? Then Allah said, tell them. So obviously the word would be the root.
Hang on, he's about to explain it now.
So he said, Allah said, tell them my prayer
is.
My prayer is. What? Can you tell us what the word
is? No.
That's the whole point. What's the word for prayer? What's the word for prayer? That's the whole point. What's the word for prayer?
The word here it used is salah. When he says, my prayer is for my servant is that my rahma, which is my mercy.
Running away.